How can I help you?
Sorry, just wandering around.
No, this is your clutch.
I know where the clutch is.
Do you want me to show you how to do this or not?
Yes, but I know where the clutch is.
Okay, fine. All right, you do it yourself, okay?
Fine.
Hey, hey, hey! What are you doing? You can't park here.
I'm just here to pick
it's
up Sarah.
It's private property. Now turn around, get the hell out of here. Come on.
Okay.
Move it.
Yep. Okay. You know what though? I think I'm just gonna wait right here. You can go back to doing your guard the cornfields thing.
This is Officer Moore at the gate. We got an issue here. Hey, listen, asshole. This is a restricted area. I told you, get the hell out of here.
Okay.
Hey, you just wait right there. I told you. Move it.
It's like I was trying to say. I'm just here
you
to pick up...
Did you not see that sign?
Oh, look at that. That's kind of hard to miss.
I'm authorized to use deadly force.
Yeah, thank you.
Whoa, what's going on?
I'm sorry, Miss Whitaker.
It's fine.
Do you know this asshole?
Yeah, he's with me. He's with me.
Sorry, ma'am. I didn't know that...
It's fine. Honestly, I apologize.
Shh. Oh, and Jim!
Deacon.
I'm not with her. She's with me.
Hold on tight.
Why do you always do that?
Do what?
Act like such a dick.
Oh, come on. He started it.
What are you, five?
Hey, watch the clutch. Remember, you gotta give it enough gas, rev up the RPMs.
I got this.
Yeah, I can hear. Where are we headed?
Over to the dam. That's a nice quiet road, right?
With you driving? No.
Are we still going out tonight? You said something might come up.
Crap, yeah. Boozer and the boys want to ride down to Klamath State, visit Jack.
So you're gonna blow me off to go see some guy in prison?
Jack's not some guy.
I know. I was kidding.
Oh, shit, look out!
Oh, God. Oh, my God. Jesus. I don't know what it is, but every time I'm on a bike with you, some idiot in a truck tries to run us off the road.
Oh, my God. No. Listen. You did great. Most people, they would have panicked. They would have oversteered, and that would have gotten us killed.
I almost did get us killed. I was...
No.
I wasn't paying attention, and I was distracted.
Hey, it's okay. Just breathe. You're okay. Wait a second. What did you mean, distracted?
No, it's just stuff going on at work. It's nothing. I just...
Oh. Okay. Now, I just thought maybe you saw my new... patch.
You're what? No. Nomad? Wait, you quit the club?
No, I didn't quit the club. I would never quit the club. Nomad, what it means is, well, I'll be less involved from now on.
Deke, I didn't ask you to do that.
Oh, I know. And if you had, I would have said no. You ready to try this again?
Yeah. I mean, no, but yeah, I will.
Thank you for saving my life.
Well, you know, I do what I can.
Hey, hey, the clutch.
I know what the clutch is.
Oh, okay, none of that.
Deacon.
So, do you think your parents are gonna come?
To the wedding? I don't know.
I mean, you know, I thought if I stepped back from the MC that,
I don't think it's gonna matter to them, Deacon.
But you're gonna at least tell them.
Yeah, if you want me to. Look, it's just, I'm not gonna change who I am and who you are to make my uptight, middle-class parents happy.
Okay. Look out.
I see them.
Hey, are they headed to your work?
Oh, shit. What about the MC? Are any of them coming now that you've gone nomad?
I don't know. It's probably been a while since any of them set foot in a chapel. And you really want 27 Harleys rolling up in that little church in Marion Forks?
Yeah. You know what? As a matter of fact, I do.
Okay.
What's going on?
I don't know.
Miss Whitaker.
Yeah?
Chief's been trying to get a hold of you, says it's urgent.
It's always urgent. Let him know I'll be right there.
Okay.
I gotta go.
Hey.
Sorry. It's fine. It's probably just a fire alarm or something small.
Okay. How come dead?
Love you. Just call me later.
Addie, I'm sorry.
Whatever.
Addie.
Whatever, Ricky.
I'm sorry.
God damn.
Clearance. O'Brien, this is St. John. Come back. O'Brien, this is St. Just answer your goddamn radio!
St. John, didn't think I'd hear from you again.
Yeah, neither did I. All right, listen, that night you bugged out. You told me that you didn't take any civilians. You just took Nero personnel, feds, people with clearance.
I told you.
Shut up. Listen to me. Sarah, my wife, she had clearance. She had her ID badge with her the night that I put her on your chopper. Do me a favor, look it up. Sarah Irene Whitaker. She worked at Cloverdale. She had federal clearance. She was doing, research, pharmaceutical. I don't know what the hell she was doing.
I'll see what I can find.
Okay, great. O'Brien, remember, you owe me.
Yeah. O'Brien out.
I wonder about the freakers sometimes, you know? Like, do they feel pain? Anything?
Hell.
St. John, this is O'Brien.
O'Brien, what do you got?
I need to see you in person.
Yeah, hold
Jesus,
on, dude.
O'Brien, just would you tell me what you found? Is she alive or isn't she?
I have something to give you.
O'Brien?
I've transmitted the coordinates. Meet me there. O'Brien out.
O'Brien? Oh, God damn it.
Deke, Iron Mike's looking for you. He said...
Boozman, listen. Just tell him I'll be back. I gotta... You remember what I told you? The night that Sarah died, Nero, they bugged out. They only took their own people, feds, and people who had federal clearance levels.
Deke, what the hell are you talking about?
Look, it's probably nothing, but there's something I gotta do. Deacon out.
possibly have left to say that I would give a damn about.
Deke, you there? I got bored. Figured I'd see if I remembered how to make anything. Stop by when you can. I think you'll like it.
Oh, booze, man. Yes, yes. I always need more shit.
Thanks, brother. Deacon out.
Okay, I'll be by. Deacon out.
Can use this.
This is Radio Free Oregon. The truth shall set you free. The war on terror, global warming, none of that matters now that we're in the shit. But it's all just part of the goddamn conspiracy. So listen up. Destruction that didn't exist. And global warming? Just a bunch of lying scientists. Well, in the pockets of those gunning to profit off of all the doom and gloom. What do you think about it? All of this? Just another way to build unrest in the people.
So your sage advice, Cope, is to assume that everyone's just lying their ass off. Is that about it? So, Jesus. That's, actually pretty good advice. For once. A little late, but it's good advice. So what the hell?
I managed to recruit a few guys who I trust, who like me, aren't happy with what's going on.
So why am I here?
I wanted to give you this. You were right about your wife.
Where did you get this?
When Silver Lake evacuated, they took Nero personnel, federal officials, and well, Sarah Irene Whitaker had a Class 4 federal clearance level.
Clearance level.
Her wife bugged out with a recon unit east of Fort Rock.
Take me there.
No.
No. Well, you got a ride. We're all friends now.
The base is gone.
What?
A year ago. Local militia group.
Militia group? Where's their camp?
I don't know.
How the hell can you not know? You got a helicopter. You got satellites.
Somewhere around Crater Lake, but it's a no-fly zone, okay? They got outposts, rockets, RPGs.
Crater Lake.
I wanted to tell you about the work we're doing. Studying the infected, the freaks. They're evolving. As bad as things are right now, they're gonna get worse. A lot worse.
Boozer, Booze Man, come back.
Yeah, Deke.
Hey, listen to me. A year ago, we were with Iron Mike. We were thinking about riding south, but the Santiam Pass was blocked. There was no way through, and he said that he knew another way.
Deke, Iron Mike, he's not too happy with us right now.
Just listen to me, just listen to me. Do you remember what he said?
Iron Mike? Yeah, he was bragging about knowing every goat trail in 100 miles. Said there was a trail that went around Mount Thiels. Thiels, I don't know, something.
Thielson, yeah, that's it. Thielson Pass.
Yeah, well, why the hell you... Shit. You've talked to... She's alive? Sarah's alive? Deke?
Okay, listen to me. O'Brien, they, Boozer, he found her ID badge. Yeah, Boozer, I think she's alive.
Deke, you never lost hope. You always knew. Never give up. So what are you gonna do?
I don't know, Boozer. I don't know, but... God, if there's even a chance that she's alive, I... Well, I gotta find her.
Goddamn right. Shit, I gotta go. Ricky and Annie need help putting up a shelf or some goddamn thing. Look, I'll see you when you get back to camp. Who's around?
See you. Hey, Ricky, I got some shit I gotta take care of.
Are you coming back?
Coming back? What do you mean?
Boozer told us.
Okay, look, there's not that town.
There's no way over the stadium pass, you know.
Yes, I'm coming back. Listen, like I said, I got some shit. You know.
There we go. Okay, made that. Something out of this. What did you drop?
Survivors not too long ago. The same Nero
that abandoned us here in this shit 2 years past. Some would call these people fools, but I got a better name for them. Traitors. And I assure you, I don't take treason lightly. But I am a reasonable man. So you get one warning. Listen up. Stop what you're doing. Now. Before we find you. Because we will. And when we do, you will pay. I'll personally string you up on the biggest tree I find. And while you're breathing your last, we'll quarter you and feed you to the freaks you love. That is a promise.
Good.
This is Mark Copeland for Radio Free Oregon. Don't believe the lies.
Yeah, well, Cope, I gotta say, I don't like it any more than you. Do your worst.
Scrap.
Thank you.
crap.
This is Radio Free Oregon.
Come on, guys, open up.
She'll set you free.
Mr.
Let me tell you.
Beacon,
before this shit, we were
dumb.
The
name of the drug
we were dumb. We were blindly taking in opiates of all kinds, keeping us sedated like fat, happy cows. Candy, television, booze, heroin, and it worked.
I had too good a day, Cope, to let your shit spoil it for me.
Stuff's getting scarce. Okay, then. Hey, always good to see you, Deke.
Yeah?
Tucker, I got him.
Nice job. I guess Wheeler's sorry he messed with Ada Tucker now.
No, I'm guessing he's not feeling a whole lot of anything.
I've updated your credits. And you wait and see. I'm still gonna find a way to talk you and Boozer into joining us here. Become a part of the family.
Yeah, good luck with that.
Yeah, I can do that.
To see you, Deacon.
What do you mean?
How's life as a camper, Alki? Same as ever?
Can I get anything else for you? Thanks. What else can I do for you? Need anything else? Good choice. Can I get anything else for you? Come by if you still need something. Let me know if you need anything else.
Yeah, thanks. I feel so much better.
It's like Boozer says, you hear a bunk calling my name.
Let's go.
Seems like the camp's better off. Thank you.
marauders. Not doing a little hunting, huh? Tired of killing folks on the road?
Hi. I guess it's kind of pointless to, say anything, since I know that you, didn't die out here. Just a habit, I guess. But, coming out here every so often, talking to you, that was, the only thing that kept me sane, you know? So, thank you. Yeah, okay. Oh, here we go. Done.
Deer crossing. Something's never changed.
Huh.
It doesn't look too bad.
How many drifters you guys murder today, huh? Yeah, I can tell by looking at you.
Okay.
You're not gonna make it out here. I know where there's a camp.
No, no, where? Where? I'll go.
Peaceful Lake. Mark Copeland. It's safe there.
Thank you so much. I thought I was gonna die in there.
Tell him it was Deacon. Deacon St. John. Okay, keep running. Stay out of sight.
That's kind of interesting. Oh, who knew?
Damn it. What, are you waiting to jump me? Huh? Damn rippers. Can't let any of them get out of here alive. A bunch of rapists and murderers.
Thank you.
Let's do this. Come on, you murdering son of a bitch.
I think that's it. Roads will be a little safer now.